Your what's up, Giants fans, Hub watchers, YouTube subscribers, Twitter and Instagram followers. It's your boy No Name back at it again with another New York Giants update video. Today I'm gonna talk about Joe Judge's comments at the New York Giants media day at the NFL Draft Combine. Just like I did with the Dave Gettleman's comments in my last video. That's really all I got to say, so let's get right into it. Now, Judge's comments, his interview was a lot longer than Gettleman's, right? But very similarly, there was a lot of questions that didn't go nowhere because Judge is just a master of the words, man. Almost anything that people asked, and they did ask, they tried to dig into his mind. They tried to dig into the Giants draft plan, their offseason plan, everything. This dude is just so smooth with redirecting the question or giving an answer that's both satisfactory but doesn't reveal anything. Like, for example, somebody asked, they asked something regarding who might be cut, who might be released, what's the depth chart right like, and Judge said, hey man, our depth chart is on that board behind me right now, nobody's got a spot. And that's the same thing he said since the moment he stepped in here. From his opening press conference, that was one of the quotes that, you know, a lot of people liked, in the sense that everybody has to earn their spot on the roster. Now, given that, I feel like we all know there's a couple players on the team who definitely, like, are gonna stay no matter what, you know, that being Saquon Barkley, Daniel Jones, you know, Dexter Lawrence. I feel like everybody from last year's draft, except for maybe the 7th round picks, are definitely gonna still be on the team. You know, the younger players, like, there's a couple guys that I feel like no matter what will be returning, especially in a Daniel Jones and in a Saquon. And in general, I like Judge's philosophy. I mean, from the moment he stepped in, like I said, that's something I really like. Everybody has to really earn their spot again. Everybody's on a clean slate. The depth chart is in a way empty. Right now, you just have to fill it in by going in there, showing him what you got on the field, off the field, in his talks with you or whatnot. Everybody, like, it's clear that Judge is a very smart guy, not just education-wise, as of course we all know he's going had a high level of education at college, but also football-wise and just, you know, with common sense. Like, he's just such a well-spoken and well-informed guy as a head coach that every time something comes out of his mouth, man, I'm like, I'm sitting straight up, I'm ready to play, I'm already ready to get on the field and whatnot. And that's really the vibe he gave off during this press conference, the very, as a lot of Giants fans will call it, the CEO like mentality of Joe Judge. And right now, like I said, on that depth chart thing, I feel like this is also saying that he might be open to cutting some players that who we think might not be cut. For example, a lot of people think that Nate Solder won't be cut because of his contract. Well, if he doesn't live up to the stuff, if he doesn't live up to what Joe Judge says, maybe he will be cut. Maybe, you know, Judge goes to Gettleman and be like, hey, we should really get rid of Solder, forget about the cap hit or whatnot. Well, you know, he's not really fit to be on the team. Maybe it's that, maybe it's not. Maybe I'm stretching a little bit, but who knows? But also, he refuses to mention any player's name because he doesn't want to create expectations for the players. And this was something he talked a lot about during the press conference. Once again, it is on the New York Giants official YouTube channel. You could go check it out. It's about an 18-minute video. Really good watch, especially if you're like really into this stuff. And he spends about a good, like, I want to say 5 minutes out of those 18 minutes talking about not wanting to set unfair expectations for players. That he's not here to make them, you know, defeat themselves mentally. The example he gave was, let's say there's a football player who has an injury. They're projected to be out for 4 to 8 weeks and they take more time than that. Let's say they're out for the entire season or something. Maybe it was worse than expected. So the media might go out there and spend stories about how this football player, we're just gonna call him Billy. I believe that's the same name he used in the video. Let's say they might be saying that Billy's not strong enough, he's not tough enough, he was only supposed to be out for X amount of weeks, instead he was out for Y amount of weeks. And then just a couple weeks later, the other football player, Bob, gets injured, and the same injury, and they're projected to be out for the same amount of time, but they come back in 3 weeks. And he's talking about this setting of expectations because then the media's been saying that, oh, Bob is tougher than Billy, Bob is a harder worker than Billy and whatnot. He's saying that he doesn't want to set expectations in any way for these players because it causes them to mentally doubt themselves and defeat themselves before they even take the first step on the field. And he doesn't want to do that with saying who's confirmed on the depth chart. He doesn't want to do that by saying, oh, we're looking for a specific position, which is, you know, one of the main reasons he's not really revealing anything. He doesn't want his guys on the team that he already has to work hard to gain their trust as their new head coach. And he's in the process of doing that. he doesn't want to lose their trust or have them doubt him anyway in their minds by providing the air of, oh, I'm looking for your replacement, or I'm looking for somebody better than you, or saying that this guy made the roster but you didn't, you might be cut. He doesn't want to create that, and I think that's really smart. It's something that not a lot of head coaches do, and just goes back to how good of the CEO type of mentality that Joe Judge has. Now, he also said, you know, when asked about whether or not they're going to be taking a quarterback at fourth overall or something like that, some question along that line. And the only reason I'm addressing this and addressing this quote is because I know there's going to be media outlets that blow it out of proportion, and there's going to be outlets claiming that, oh, Judge wants to trade Daniel Jones and whatnot. I firmly believe that's not what he's going to do. But the answer that he gave off and the answer that Gettleman gave off very much coincided with each other in that they're going to take the best player available. You know, with Judge saying that nobody's on the board, Gettleman saying the best player available, I'm just going to go out on a limb and say they're going to keep Daniel Jones on the roster. I don't know, maybe because maybe because Gettleman took him sixth overall last year. He's proved that he's a worthy quarterback and that he's worthy of playing out at least his rookie contract in his rookie year, where he only played, I believe it was 12 games, and was only a couple touchdowns away from breaking the rookie touchdown record. Proved both the media and haters wrong by showing that he could make all the NFL throws, as they say, that he could function well in and outside the pocket. Yes, he has mistakes to clean up, but he's a rookie. It happens. I mean, I just feel like this is a narrative that's going to get started up, if it already hasn't been started, as we get closer and closer to the draft, just because it's drama and just because it's something that, you know, the media could sell, you know, channels out there like ESPN and FS1 and whatnot. They're going to try and sell the fact that, oh, Gettleman and Judge are not sold on Daniel Jones, or they're not committed to Daniel Jones. What could possibly happen there? And of course, I'm here to say to you guys, and I'm sure you guys already know, that's just BS. They are committed to him. He is the franchise quarterback for now. We'll see how he goes. And the reason they're saying what they're saying goes back to A, not wanting to reveal your plan to other teams, and B, not wanting to have doubts being planted in anybody's mind by stating a specific position of what you're going to take. And Gettleman's been saying this for the past 2 years, we're going to take the best player overall. It's not anything new. And listen, even if they do for some reason, and I don't even want to state it, because I feel like if I state it, I'm putting it out there in the universe and it could happen. I'm not superstitious, I'm just a little stitious. But I don't even want to say it. If they do what I described that they might do, and that's a very confusing sentence, but if they do that, I don't even know how I would feel, because I feel like Daniel Jones has proved himself. I feel like it would be stupid to take a quarterback sixth overall and somewhat get rid of him and take another quarterback in your next draft when you're already starting to build a team around him, and you brought in a bunch of offensive-minded coaches that would greatly help him improve and whatnot. I just feel like it would be stupid, but it's something that needs to be said, because we saw this last year with the Arizona Cardinals. Granted, Daniel Jones is way better than Josh Rosen at this point in their careers to me. He definitely performed better. And there is somebody in this draft that the Giants wanted last year in a Justin Herbert. But once again, the Giants last year, both as a team and as the front office and organization, is very different from the Giants as of February 25th, 2020. All right, but I just got to put it out there. That's what I got for y'all today. The rest of the interview, the rest of the press conference is really interesting, really good, but those were the major, major quotes I wanted to address. And of course, the things that I needed to address, because I feel like the narrative is going to start. But let me know what you all think. Put your comments down below. I'm out. Alright guys, thanks for watching. Put your comments down below. Make sure you smash that like button, subscribe, and turn on post notifications. Until next time, I'm out.